like, at this service, we didn't have anybody at a party.
But you're sort of assuming that maybe that has to do with the fact that there are people coming to town. Any takers?
All right. You guys all look so cool and comfortable. It's in here. Okay. Well, I want to ask you a question. How many of you have ever set up a lemonade stand out in front of your house to sell lemonade on hot days like this? Maybe somebody has, or if you've thought about it, or you've seen somebody do something like that, come on in. Lots of time. Just getting started. Hi. Lemonade that sometimes people sell out in front of their houses, maybe for 25 cents, maybe for 50 cents per glass, so that people can have something cool to drink. Now, my son used to love to do that sort of thing, and of course, mom had to go out and buy all the goods to make sure that that happened, but I was pretty happy to do that because it showed to me a welcome and generous spirit. Especially on a hot day like this, cold lemonade would taste pretty good, wouldn't it? And that would be one thing, even though, and sometimes there are lemonade stands where people just stop and whoever is setting up the stand, they just say, here, it's free lemonade. Come and have something cold to drink. That would be what we would call hospitality. Now that's a big word. But basically what it means is to make yourself available to help people, to give them something cold to drink, to welcome them into your space, show them that you care about them and that you want to help them and to be with them in that particular time. Hospitality happens in your own houses when family comes over for dinner or when they come and have a beer for a party and they invite people to come. That's what hospitality is, to welcome people into our midst. Sometimes, however, when we welcome people into our lives in those kinds of ways, sometimes we get a little fussy about making sure that everything's neat and tidy. Do you keep, all of you keep your rooms absolutely spotless all the time? Yes? No? Well, okay, you know what? I didn't either at your age, not very much. I used to have to get pounded by my mother to clean up and to change sheets and do all of that stuff. But sometimes we can get a little caught up in making sure that everything looks good and tidy, and then we forget about people that we're inviting over to share a day with us, or an evening with us, or a meal with us. Well, Jesus has a little conversation with a woman named Martha and tries to tell her that it's not so much important to be all upset about whether everything is perfect. What's important is welcoming him into her home. And so too, you and I, when we have that opportunity to welcome people, Jesus tells us when we do that with other people, it is as if we are welcoming Jesus himself. That's important because we want to be good hosts for Jesus when he comes into our lives. And he is always in our presence. We try to do that in a way that shows our love and devotion to him. Okay? So we welcome people. We look after them. We don't get all upset about whether there's a little smudge on the couch or any of that stuff. We worry about the people that are here to share an important moment with us, knowing that they too are here. Now, let's back up. I keep cutting in a little bit. I don't know what that scene or whatever, but anyway, let's bow our heads for a word and let's talk about faith. Thank you, God, for loving us and receiving us into your presence. Help us to be good hosts for people who want to be close to you and who also have needs that we can provide. Amen. You may have a seat. Am I going to see all of you tonight for Bible school? Okay, cool. I hope so. We're going to have a ball. It's going to be a lot of fun. Okay. Yeah. Go ahead. You may have a seat.